वेलकम वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिसेस दर्शना संदीप शिंदे. टुडे वी डील विद द एक्सट्रैक्शन. लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ अवर टुडे सेशन. आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो स्टूडेंट्स आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड रिकॉग्नाइज व्हाट इज एक्सट्रैक्शन, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्शन, सॉल्वेंट्स यूज फॉर द एक्सट्रैक्शन, इन्फ्यूजन एंड डिकॉक्शन. इन दिस टॉपिक वी focus on only the infusion and decoction only. First of all, we see the what is meant by extraction. Extraction may be defined as the treatment of plant tissue or animal with the solvent whereby medicinally active constituents are dissolved and the most of the inert matter remain undissolved in that. If you want to extract or if you want, we want the chemical constituents of some plant origin or animal origin, for that person active, for to collect that active constituents, we dip that plant or the animal constituent into the water or any other suitable solvent. The various processes are used for extraction are infusion, decoction, maceration, percolation and digestion. First of all, we see the detailed classification of this extraction process. Extraction is mainly divided into the first infusion, then decoction, then maceration, then percolation, and last one is the digestion. This is mainly divided into these five categories. After that, this infusion is also has two parts. It is obtained from the fresh infusion and concentrated infusion also. Then decoction is only by boiling of plant or animal constituent with the water. Then maceration is again divided into the simple maceration with the adjustment, and multiple maceration. And this multiple maceration is divided into double maceration and triple maceration. Then percolation is divided into simple percolation, percolation for concentrated preparations, and continuous percolation process. This percolation for concentrated preparation is again divided into reserve percolation process and modified percolation process. Maceration means dipping of a liquid into the dipping of plant constituent or animal constituent in a suitable solvent and kept it for the 24 hours to the several days. It has a main three types. Afterwards, multiple maceration is divided into two: double maceration and triple. Percolation also has a divided into three parts: simple percolation, percolation for concentrated preparation, and continuous percolation process. This percolation for concentrated preparation again divided into reserve percolation and modified percolations. Then we see the mark. What is meant by mark? The drug residue which remain behind the after extraction is known as the mark. That means that filtrate we collected on filter paper or cloth is known as the mark. Then menstruum, solvent used to extract the drug. That means we dip our drug into the solvent, that it is known as the menstruum. Then we see the ideal properties of the menstruum. It should be cheap one, it should be non-toxic, it should be stable chemically as well as the physically stable. Then selective, it should have a selective in their action, that means remove to desired active constituents with the minimum amount of, and it should have inert material. Then following solvents are generally used for the extraction. Generally water and alcohol, these are the generally used solvents are used for the extraction process. First of all, we see the water. It is used as a solvent for protein, coloring matter, gums, glycosides, sugar, alkaloidal salts, enzymes, and many organic acids and most of the organic salts. Waxes, fats, fixed oil, most alkaloids are insoluble in the water. That's why for the waxes, fixed oil, fats, water is not used as a solvent. Then we see the advantages of water. Water is a cheap one. It is easy to available. It has a wide solvent action. It is a non-toxic one, though it is a neutral. It is a non-inflammable also. These are the advantages of the water. Then we see the disadvantages of water as a solvent. Fermentation, decomposition of the preparation, chances to produce the undesirable substance and interfere with the clarity of the preparation. Though it contains the oxygen, that means it is a fermentation also occurred, decomposition also occurred. Use of the preservative, water caused hydrolysis of many substances. This is the disadvantages of the water. Then large amount of heat is required compared with the non-aqueous preparation. Water required large amount of heat. Other non-aqueous preparations do not require large amount of heat. Then we see the alcohol as a solvent. It is used as a solvent for the alkaloid, alkaloidal salt, glycoside, volatile oil and resin. It is also dissolved many of the coloring matter, tannins, many organic acids, salt, gums and albuminous matter, gums, waxes, fats, fixed oil, sugar are not soluble in the alcohol. But some of the waxes, fats, most of the time they are soluble. Then we see the advantages of alcohol as a solvent. Bacterial growth do not occur. Alcohol do not promote the bacterial growth. Then it is a neutral and compatible with the other products. It should be compatible and it should be neutral. Alcohol is neutral one, that's why it is compatible with the most of the products. Then it is a non-toxic one. It do not produce any contamination or any reaction with the other drug. A small amount of heat is required to concentrate the alcoholic preparations. For the concentration of alcoholic preparation, small amount of heat required, but very less heat required than the water. It dissolves selective active constituents of the drug. Then we see the disadvantages of alcohol. The main disadvantages of alcohol as a solvent is its cost, though it is costly. The preparation become costly when alcohol is used as a solvent for the extraction of active constituents of the drug. Only the cost is the major disadvantages of alcohol. Then we see the processes used for the extraction. The first process is infusion. It consists of pouring water over the drug and then allow to keep it in contact with the water for the stated period of the time. That means we have to dip the drug into the water for the stated period of time, usually 15 minutes, with the occasional stirring and finally filtering of the liquid. The mark is not pressed. In the infusion mark, that means filtered with collected over that or cloth or filter paper, it is not pressed. Then boiling water is commonly used as a solvent for the infusion since it has a great solvent action than the cold water. Boiling water is more preferred, but sometimes cold water is also preferred for the infusion. Then we see the apparatus. Coffee pot or teapot is the simplest form of the apparatus used for preparing the infusion. Coffee pot or a fruit extract pot is used for the extraction process, this infusion process. Simply, here is a filter, hot water is placed, then coffee is placed. In that hot water is placed and mix, and we get a proper infusion. Then two types of infusion, fresh infusion and concentrated infusion. First of all, we see the fresh infusion. Aqueous liquid is used as a menstruum, that means water is used as a menstruum. It is prepared by coarse drug plus hot water and then filter for to sometimes. That means to kept it for 15 minutes and then filter out. As per pharmacopoeia, it is used within the 12 hours after formulation. Example of its fresh infusion of the cassia. Then concentrated infusion, it is 8 times stronger than the fresh infusion. In that, 20-25% concentrated alcohol is used as infusion. In fresh infusion, there is only water is used as in menstruum, but in concentrated, 20-25% of alcohol is used as a menstruum. It is prepared by double or triple maceration. Double maceration, that means we dip the drug into 24 hours, after that filter it. after filtration, that mark is not thrown out. In that mark, we mix some kind of other, or we mix the same kind of menstruum into it, kept it for again 24 hour, and again doing the extraction process. This is a double time. We keep all the process, or we prefer, or we perform all the process. It is known as double maceration process. If this process is done for the third time, that means after collecting a second time mark, in that mark add the sufficient quantity of menstruum and repeat all the process, it is known as the triple maceration process. It can be stored for a longer period of the time also. Example of concentrated infusion is a concentrated infusion of cassia. Then we see the decoction. What is meant by decoction? In this process, the drug is boiled with the water for a stated period of the time. In this, we boil the drug. We do not infusion, we add the boiled water. Here we boil the drug for the 10 minutes. Then after boiling, the liquid is stained. After boiling, the liquid is stained and water is passed through the content of the stainer to make the required volume. This process is mainly used for the vegetable drugs of a hard and woody nature, having the thermostable water soluble constituents. That means those drugs which are hard and woody, that decoction can be preferred. Then we see the difference between the, what is the difference between infusion and the decoction. In infusion, cold or boiling water is used as a menstruum. In decoction, drug is boiled within the water. This is the main difference. Infusion, we can use cold and boiling water as a menstruum, and here is drug is boiled within the water. Then in infusion, drug having soft tissue is used. Decoction for the hard tissue, decoction is used. Then for infusion, infusion is for the drug constituent, maybe volatile constituents of the drug, we use the infusion, we do not use the decoction. Decoction is used for the drug constituent, should be non-volatile, because we boil that drug for a specific period of time. If the volatile material is there, all the volatile constituent will be the volatile one. That's why for the decoction process, we use the non-volatile material. Then infusion, final volume is not adjusted in the infusion. In the decoction process, final volume is adjusted one. In infusion, when boiling water is used as a menstruum, precautions are taken to prevent the escape of the heat by covering the vessel with the cloth. That means boiling, if we use the boiling water, we can cover that vessel with the cloth to prevent the evaporation or prevent the heat loss. In decoction, no such precaution is required because the final volume is adjusted at the end. In decoction, we can adjust the final volume. In infusion, we do not adjust. That's why we prevent the evaporation of the water by covering the vessel with the cloth. This is the difference between the infusion and the decoction. Infusion is dipping of drug constituent into hot and cold water and to get the extract. And decoction means boiling of a drug into the water or suitable menstruum. Then we move toward the summary. In this session, we covered what is meant by extraction, then classification of extraction process, then solvents used for extraction. In that we see infusion, decoction, difference between the infusion and decoction also.